short pieces from all different composers, but all those pieces will have one thing in common: beautiful melodies. So today we would like to focus specifically on melodies. And when I say short, if they are not short enough, we'll make them short. First piece is by a composer who, in the shadow of his contemporary stars like Debussy and Ravel, composed quietly beautiful, beautiful music. And that's Gabriel Fauré, and here's our take on his lovely Pavane. Thank you. Thank you very much. That was Pavan by Gabriel Fauré. In the next piece, we'll try to welcome long anticipated spring. And we will use for that beautiful theme from Tchaikovsky and frame it sort of by a beautiful melody called Versus by Chopin. And Versus in French, I've been told, is lullaby. Here it is. next piece, I would like to share a little bit of my childhood memory with you. When I was about six, we had a cottage in the country, and in this cottage there was no electricity. But my father owned a very strange machine that we thought at that time, I was 6 or 8, that was old-fashioned gramophone with a huge green kind of tube. And especially on the evenings when it was rainy and boring, he used to put the old records on it. He'd got only 3 or 4 of them, so me and my sister would learn quickly all those pieces, at least to recognize them. But this beautiful machine makes kind of noise, like maybe you can remember old records used to do. You put the old records on and you, first of all, what you hear is kind of, you know. And strangely enough, whenever I hear those, one of those pieces now, I always hear in the background this noise. So I would like to play at least a little bit of one of those pieces. And if you can try imagine in the background this shh noise, you may have fun with it, I don't know. Let's try it. Thank you. Thank you. We would like to turn now to composer that was his tremendous volume of work was greatly appreciated, mostly after his death. We're talking about Franz Schubert. He composed some 600 songs, only songs. Of course, on the top of songs, few symphonies and chamber music and piano music and so on and so on. But anyway, we want to play our kind of arrangement of theme from his piano trio in B flat that we think this piece has a special message. So this is like a conversation between female and male, sometimes very gently and loving, sometimes very rough. Woman voice will be represented by melody playing on piano, and men voice, of course, will be represented by melody played on bass. And a conclusion on end of piece. Try to not take that too seriously. Thank you. That was whole message that in a healthy relationship, the last word should belong to woman. Is that right conclusion? Anyway, that's what we think Schubert want to say. But again, he lived only 31 years, so that was young life. Maybe he wasn't that experienced. You know, some composers like to make there is a message regarding what Bill's music is all about a little bit more precise than Schubert. So we'll try to play a little bit of Chopin, concerto in major. According to his comments. I do not want to be strong, but rather romantic, quiet, melancholic. It should leave the impression of a place which brings thousands of sweet memories to one's mind. It is like a lovely springtime dream, but at the moonlight. Thank you. Thank you very much. That was a love story because Chopin, when composed that, he was barely 20 years old and lovely, and hopelessly in love with a lovely lady without accepting the name. So that was a really true love story for Chopin. So, speaking of love story, we may just jump over the pond to the west and find the other one somewhere by Bernstein, of course. All right. Now, I would like to play piece by Chopin, and particularly because of one person, of Władysław Szpilman. For those who are not familiar with his name, he was the musician, pianist, that Roman Polański did the famous movie Pianist about him. So he was, after the war, very popular person in Warsaw, first of all because he was the director of programming in Polish radio. So anything that plays on Polish radio couldn't be played without his personal approval. So you can imagine he was very popular. And secondly, he was the owner of the only Rolls-Royce car in Warsaw. Can you imagine that? That was popularity that was unmatched. I've got the pleasure to meet him once, very shortly. That was very funny. Zdzisław met him a few times, but that may be subject for another time, because that was very interesting. Always meeting him was very interesting. But anyway, this piece, if you remember the movie, Spielmann was recording this piece in a Polish radio studio and was interrupted by German bombs falling down on Warsaw. And Polański chose this piece brilliantly because this piece is all about love and peace and quiet. So the effect of falling bombs on a studio was, you know, doubled or tripled. Here it is. Thank you. Next piece we want to do is our take on Again by Frédéric Chopin, and reflect on his very unfortunate and almost tragic trip, vacation trip to Mallorca with George Sound and her family. At some point, he was so distressed that he wrote to his friend a letter, and he described it. He said, "The silence is piercing my ears to the point of unbearable pain." So you can imagine what stage he was, and we want to reflect that, and that is our take on his prelude in C minor. Remind you, all those preludes, most of them, he composed in such a terrible environment. So this was composed in Mallorca.
Thank you.
thank you. I am watching my clock, don't worry. I'm watching my clock, don't worry. We should jump a little bit ahead. Maybe a little bit. Okay, I have two wonderful people here that we didn't expect to see today, but we are so grateful that you came, Mrs. and Mr. Spiro. People who are guilty of all this event happening from 25 years, every Wednesday, something that is almost unachievable. And I know those lovely people for a long, long, long time. And I wasn't expecting to see them today, but I know that Mr. Spiro is very passionate about music. And his idol is Gustav Mahler. He probably knows every single note from Mahler's music and every single episode of his life. I am absolutely sure of it. So we have no choice today but play something to, hopefully, to his liking, even at the risk that he will call me tomorrow and he will say, George, stay away from Mahler's music, please. But anyway, we'll take that risk. Here's our take on his lovely adagietto from Symphony No. 5. Thank you. Thank you. At least it was short. One more? One more, okay, so.
Two?
Okay, yeah, oh, okay, two, all right. Okay, let us jump a little bit north to Norway. When this country was very young and capital Oslo was still called Christiania, they have two giants. One was Ibsen, another was Grieg. And we want to play a little bit of collaboration from those two, which is play per game. We will throw a few other teams from other pieces into it. So here it is, our take on melodies from Per Gynt. Thanks. Thank you, and we don't one more yet, so some short one. Another prelude by Chopin that was composed in the same very difficult environment and And somehow he managed to compose such a beautiful, timeless music. Of course, that would be our take, so not as beautiful as Chopin thought, but anyway, something ours. Thank you. That will be all for today, and thank you for coming, and we are so proud to be part of this wonderful event, and till the next time. Maybe next time we'll tell you a story about Vladislav Spiman. Thank you.
Oh, how beautiful was that? Thank you so much, George Boski and Jisma. Deepest thank you to Tauba and Solomon Spiro Family Foundation for making this concert series possible and bringing live music back to the Princess Margaret Cancer Center. We thank you all so much for coming, and we hope that you enjoyed the music. We'll be back next Wednesday at noon, and we hope to see you all there. Have a wonderful rest of your week, everyone.